relationship advice. Update. My, 28 female, husband's, 30 male, older brother, 35 male, confessed that he's in love with me. What the hell do I do? Original story. This happened last week. I am still shocked and have no idea what to do with this information. A little backstory, my husband and I have been friends since I was in middle school, so we've known each other, and each other's families, forever. We started dating after college and got married 2 years ago. Let's call my husband Greg and his older brother Michael. I've obviously known Michael just as long as I've known Greg, but in that vague, peripheral way, you know, a friend's older brother? He was already well into college by the time I met and started hanging out with Greg, so until we got married, I hadn't had a lot of contact with him except for holidays when everyone was home. Michael and his wife, let's call her Stephanie, have been separated for over a year and are in the process of getting divorced. He primarily cares for their 6-year-old son. Stephanie moved out of state. Michael is an ER physician and has been insanely busy since COVID started, especially since their son's daycare is still closed. Since I'm able to work remotely, I've stepped in to help out with babysitting. As a result, I've had more interaction with Michael, but still, it's not much. Just him getting home exhausted from work, saying thanks. Me saying some version of, no worries, happy to spend time with my nephew. And then I leave. Nothing romantic, no ulterior motives, nothing weird. Then, last week, as I was gathering up my laptop and stuff getting ready to go home, Michael said, "Hey, I really need to talk to you about something that's been bugging me. I honestly thought it was going to be that I had done something wrong in caring for his son, letting him do/eat something he wasn't supposed to or something like that. But then, he essentially told me that he's been in love with me for years, and that his feelings toward me were a contributing factor in him leaving Stephanie, and seeing me with his son and coming home to me every night has been wonderful. He then said, I understand you're with Greg, but I had to tell you how I feel." I sort of blacked out from shock, mumbled something about needing to get home, and left. I can't stress enough how little one-on-one contact Michael and I have had. Like, I don't think I've ever even hugged him. If you added up all the words we've ever spoken to each other, it might comprise a 30-minute conversation. He's almost like a father/teacher figure to me. I certainly don't feel the same way about him and am blown away that not only is he apparently in love with me, how? But I was a contributing factor in his divorce? Which means Stephanie knows how he feels. Because I know some problematic people will ask, no, I have never let him on, worn anything even remotely revealing in front of him, texted him about anything other than childcare logistics, or spent more than 10 minutes alone with him. I'm honestly more confused than anything because, from my perspective, he knows nothing about me, like we barely talk. How the hell can he think he's in love with me? I've avoided him entirely since it happened, saying I had a bunch of meetings and couldn't babysit last week, which I feel really guilty about because I love spending time with my nephew. I haven't told anyone else, especially my husband. Please help, this is so far above my pay grade, and probably above Reddit's as well, but have no idea what to do. I don't want to cause a weird rift between brothers, or not be able to see my nephew anymore. Any advice is welcome. Thanks. Top advice before we read the update. Tell your husband what's going on and explain that's why you've been dodging his brother. Brother-in-law may think he's in love, but most likely is using what he thinks he knows about you as an ideal to hold up for his failed marriage. This. As you've pointed out, brother-in-law barely knows you. He's created an idea of you in his mind and fallen in love with it. This sometimes happens when people are unhappy in their lives and close themselves off from being involved in the people around them. He was likely unhappy with his wife and during that time continued to imagine a life with you, building you up into someone you have never been. Be sure to mention this to your husband. I think that your brother-in-law needs clear boundaries, but not a kick in the teeth. He likely needs therapy. If he isn't in love with her, he's in love with the idea of her. Step 1, show husband this post. The information is going to cross husband's path eventually and it's really important that you're the one to tell him. You don't want him finding out plus finding out you know plus you elected not to tell him. Real step 2. Avoid contact and start treating your mental and emotional health. Blacking out from stress is a sign of trauma. But just like any wound, can heal. Green grass, blue skies. Tell your husband. The brother needs to be called out on his stupidity. Sounds like he's had a tough run, might have got a bit too intense and found comfort in any female in close proximity, it happens. Yep, this exactly, at least if we want to give the brother the benefit of the doubt, which I usually like to do if possible. Now for the update. Damn, I had no idea this would blow up. I honestly thought I'd get like 3 responses. Thank you to everyone who offered their kind advice and insight on my situation. This is going to be super long, but here it goes. My husband is my best freaking friend, has been since I was 12 years old. Keeping this from him for 5 days was the hardest thing I've ever done. I was sick to my stomach and could barely sleep. A special F you to those commenters who insinuated that I was lying and had actually been in love with freaking Michael the entire time, and am using this as an excuse to get out of cheating. Who hurt you? I knew, even before posting on here, that I needed to tell my husband. But, being the conflict-averse, socially awkward/anxious person I am, I sort of hoped this would all go away if I just ignored it like nothing happened, or pretend I had gone spontaneously deaf. I didn't want it to turn into some huge deal that made every family get-together impossibly awkward. But the responses I received here were overwhelmingly, "Tell your goddamn husband." Yesterday, Tuesday, morning, I told my husband everything. His initial response, no joke, was, laughing, "What?" Followed immediately by, "Oh my god, this is totally my fault." Incredulous, I asked him how this could possibly be his fault. He explained that when Michael and Stephanie were still married, whenever they would have issues in their relationship, Michael would confide in Greg, who in turn would offer his advice and support. Being a protective little brother upset about how Michael was being treated by his wife, Greg would apparently always use me as the good example in contrast to Stephanie's bad. She was a bit of an a-hole to be fair, insisting that Michael deserved better, deserved to have a relationship like we did, a wife who loved him as much as I loved Greg. I then pointed out the obvious, that this was neither his fault, nor mine, and that Michael was definitely not in love with me, but the idea of me, dashed first as the wife he wanted but did not have, then as the mother to his child. We agreed that the situation has been compounded by the unimaginable stress he's been under since the global situation, and he probably saw me as the only stable, loving presence in his and his son's life. Because my husband is the kindest, most empathetic, most amazing man on earth, and probably a better brother than Michael deserves to be honest, he wasn't even angry. He was sad. He knew, as well as I did, that Michael was not actually in love with me. We agreed we would talk to Michael together, suggest therapy, and continue supporting him and caring for our godson. We also agreed that no matter what happened, we would not let that little boy be the collateral damage in this awkward, unnecessary mess, especially when his parents have divorced, his own mother has all but abandoned him, and a global pandemic has prevented him from seeing his kindergarten friends as often. Dash, he needs, and deserves, a stable, loving, normal environment in which to be a kid. Greg and I decided that we would watch our nephew together yesterday, at our house. Greg texted Michael that he would be working from home, and to drop the boy off on his way to the hospital. When Michael got off work and came to pick up his son, I was upstairs, leaving them to talk. After they had talked for about an hour and a half, Greg called me downstairs. Both of them had been crying. Michael apologized to me, and to Greg, profusely, total mea culpa. He insisted his intention in confessing his feelings was meant more as a compliment to what an amazing wife I am to Greg, and how happy you make my son, and that was what motivated him to finally leave Stephanie 2 years ago, not wanting to be with me and take me away from Greg, but realizing that I, or, more realistically, someone like me, was what he wanted/deserved. He said he realized it was selfish of him to unload his feelings on me like that, and he knew I wouldn't reciprocate them, but that he felt he would go insane if he didn't just effing say something, with everything else on his plate right now. He said he had been feeling this way for a couple of years and planned to just work through it alone and take it to his grave, but that it just sort of came out like word vomit, and he never in a zillion freaking years would have acted on it. Michael also made a point to underscore the fact that these romantic feelings toward me are quite new, developing about 5 years ago, and were in no way predatory, since he's known me since I was 12 and he was 20. Michael agreed to seek therapy. Greg and I even offered to join him in the sessions if he thought it would be helpful. Greg and I will also still be helping him with his son. He works insane hours and is new to the whole single dad thing. Any babysitting will be done at our house, not Michael's from now on. For those pointing out that Michael can afford alternative childcare for his son, dash that's not the point, dash his son, our godson, needs a stable environment filled with family and routine since his life has been pretty much uprooted by the divorce, his mom leaving, and the pandemic. Until his school resumes in-person classes next spring, we'll care for him as a family. Greg and Michael's sister and parents, while they know nothing of this mess, share in the responsibility as well, so it will not be totally on our hands. All in all, I don't think any of us could have hoped for a better outcome to this weird A situation. Happy to have everything out in the open so we can move forward. Thanks again for all of your advice and kind words. I have the best husband, salt of the earth, that one. Now for the closing comments. This is beautiful. A wonderful victory for empathy and understanding. Your story gives me a margin of hope. Thank you. Amazing way to handle things and a fantastic outcome for all involved. So glad things worked out for the best. I have to say thank you to OP for posting this. After reading both posts, I am thrilled to see the resolution. The way all parties handled this situation is inspirational to the type of conflict resolution and communication I would want in my own life. Your husband sounds like a fantastic man, and I deeply respect his empathy for his brother. I hope your brother-in-law gets better and that the stresses of the pandemic get easier on him. I can't even imagine what it's like. Thanks again for letting Reddit learn from your experiences and perspective. Now for the final story. My ex-boyfriend, 26 male, is marrying my best friend, 24 female, but he just told me that he wished he was marrying me instead, 24 female. I dated my ex-boyfriend from 4th grade to 11th grade, and from 12th grade I started dating my current boyfriend. When I broke up with my ex, my best friend told me that she had liked him for a while, but she didn't do anything since we were dating. She asked if I was comfortable with her expressing interest to my ex, and I told her that she could do anything she wanted. After some time, my ex-boyfriend started to date my best friend. This wasn't as weird as it sounds, since after 12th grade, we all went separate ways. So, while they were dating, it wasn't like I was right next to them the whole time. We got time to mature fully and independently, and while some people wouldn't understand, I was glad my ex and my best friend was dating. I knew my ex was a good person, good enough for my best friend, and that they would go along nicely. Me and my boyfriend moved far away during university, and we lost contact with those two for a while. We came back home because of the pandemic, and we found out they were engaged. It was amazing, and it was one of the best days of my life, because I was welcomed with good news and got to see my old friends again. I got to have a conversation with my ex-boyfriend, reminiscing and laughing about the past, joking and looking back at time. I told him that I was so happy for him, and that if he didn't know what to give my best friend as gifts, or was having any relationship issues, to call me, since I knew them to the best. He laughed, and we reconnected our contacts, which we lost over the time. Last night, I was about to go to sleep when he called me, and I answered the phone. He told me that when he was looking back at the time, he wished he could turn back time so we would never break up and that it would be us marrying. He said that maybe in another universe we would be getting married, and that he would trade anything to get to do that. He said that he respected my boyfriend, but that we were always meant to be. He waited for my reply, which I didn't speak and just ended the call. I pretended it didn't happen, but seeing my best friend post about planning her wedding and being so excited is breaking my heart. If I was in her position, I would want to know, but I don't want to destroy her happiness. Would she resent me if I didn't tell her? Would it be better for her to not know? Now for the top advice. Very inappropriate of your ex. Now his bride is in for a rough life with a man carrying that fantasy land regret. I'm sure I'll get down votes from the people that believe you should always tell the absolute truth, but I really do think you should remove yourself from the situation and say nothing. In all likelihood, he has a bad case of cold feet and you're the perfect scapegoat. You walked back into their lives right when he was needing an excuse. Yes. I think so too. Maybe all she really needs to do is break up with him all over again. Firmly. They both have changed so much over the years. Who they were then is so not who they are now. So, he is definitely living in a fantasy world of some kind. This is a situation of damned if you do and damned if you don't. If you tell her, she might believe you or not, but it's unlikely that she'll be grateful. If you don't tell her and later she is unhappy, you are going to be partially responsible, because you are going to think that if you spoke up, things would be different. No one knows the future, but no matter what you decide, you are going to be the villain, probably. Choose what is going to let you sleep at night and accept whatever happens next. I don't know, man, I would want to know if my soon-to-be husband was calling up my best friend late at night, saying that he wishes he would have married her. Cold feet or not, that was highly inappropriate. And I think you should tell your boyfriend first and tell your best friend. And that's it for this video, guys. If you have thoughts to share, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you like this content. Turn the notification on to get updated on my latest posts. I'll catch you in the next one. Good day, everyone.